Let me now share about what we know about this novel coronavirus. This virus comes from the family of coronavirus, which includes other viruses such as MERS and SARS, as well as the milder variants causing common cold. The medical consensus at this moment is that the novel coronavirus is more transmissible, but appears less deadly than SARS. Available evidence suggests that the rate of human-to-human transmission of this virus appears to be higher than that of SARS. For now, the evidence also suggests that transmission is mostly via droplets. What this means is that the virus is carried within droplets emitted from an infected person over a short distance, such as when a person coughs or sneezes. If these droplets come into contact with the eyes, nose or mouth of an individual directly or indirectly through hands that have come into contact with these droplets, the individual may become infected. To clarify, there is no evidence currently to suggest that the virus is airborne. There are other viruses, such as the chickenpox, which can easily be transported via air currents, and do not require droplets to contact the eyes or nose. The novel coronavirus is not in this category of viruses. The novel coronavirus could also transmit through surface contact. Let me explain. When a person sneezes or coughs, the droplets fall onto the surfaces of tables and chairs, for example, and the virus may remain alive for up to a few days. When someone else touches the surfaces of these tables and chairs, the virus can be transferred to his hands, and if he then rubs his eyes or nose without washing his hands, he may become infected. So we should wash our hands. This is also why we only quarantine the close contacts of confirmed cases. For more transient contacts, such as individuals that the confirmed cases may have walked past in malls or hotels, the risk of transmission is low. For coronavirus generally, the person is most infectious when he is displaying symptoms, or what you call symptomatic. And this is likely to be the case for the novel coronavirus as well. The most effective way that we can protect ourselves is to practice good personal hygiene. We should regularly wash our hands with soap and water and avoid touching our face with our hands.